Pleasant morning to my dear students. Welcome to TennyMax. Now we are moving same chapter number 1, exercise 1.3, question number 1, subdivision 4. The same concept we should be apply matrix inversion method. What is the formula matrix inversion method? Capital AX is equal to B means first we have to make it each and every time in matrix form. What we have to do? First term 1, 1, 1. Second row 6 minus 4 positive 5. 6 minus 4 positive 5. Third one 5, 2, 2. So 5, 2, 2. Then x means x, y, z. Then is equal to constant will be b. Constant, what is actually constant term? So minus 2 bring out opposite side means so positive 2. Again minus 31 bring out opposite side means positive 31. Already we know third equation is equal to, they have given clearly what is a constant actually 13. Okay, so 2, 31, 13. Now this is called capital A, this is called capital X, constant will be the name of capital B. Then we need capital X as it is, A bring out opposite side means A inverse into B. So how to find out the A inverse? 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. So 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A means, so first we need to find out determinant of A. Sign conversion plus minus plus means determinant of A. 1 means minus 4 into 2 minus 8. Again cross multiply means minus 10. Next term minus means 6 into 2 positive 12. Cross multiply 5 5s are 25. Third term plus 1 into 6 2s are 12. Cross multiply means plus 20. Therefore 1 minus 8 minus 10 minus 18. Next term 12 minus 25 means minus 13. Again next term plus 1 into 12 plus 20 means 32. Okay. So now if you remove the bracket, bracket remove pandrom, minus 18, minus into minus, plus 13, next term again plus 32. So listen my dear friends, 32 plus 13 means 45, 45 minus 18 is equal to 27. So answer determinant of A is equal to 27, definitely we can say not equal to 0, therefore A inverse exists. After getting the exist term, then so determinant A is over. Now we need to find out adjoint of A. What is the name of adjoint of A? Adjoint of A means the transpose of cofactor matrix. So transpose of cofactor matrix. So first we need to find out cofactor. What is the sign conversion? Plus minus plus, again minus plus minus plus minus plus. This is actually sign conversion symbol. Then one by one we need to apply. Plus means minus 4 into 2 means minus 8. Then cross multiply means minus minus 10, because 5 into 2 means 10. So minus 8 minus 10 means minus 18. The first term actually minus 18. Next sign conversion, minus sign is there. Then we need to write it. Next one actually 6 into 2, 12. Cross multiply means 5 into 5, 25. So 12 minus 25 means minus 13. Minus 13. Third term actually sign conversion plus actually. So again 6 into 2 means 12. Cross multiply means plus 20. So 12 plus 20 means 32. 32. Okay. Next term. This is sign conversion minus. Again 1 into 2 means 2. Again cross multiply means 2, so 2 minus 2 means value will be 0 is there. Okay, next sign conversion actually plus. If you remove, if you skip right hand column of minus 4 means 1 into 2 means 2, 2 minus 5, so answer will be minus 3. Next term actually sign conversion minus. Again 1 into 2 means 2, cross multiply minus 5, therefore 2 minus 5 is equal to minus 3. Then third row sign conversion actually plus sign. Again 1 into 5, 5. Cross multiply means plus 4. 5 plus 4 is equal to 9. Next sign conversion minus. Then again if you skip row and column of 2 means 1 into 5, 5. 5 minus 6 is equal to minus 1. Next term actually we have sign conversion plus sign. again 1 into minus 4, minus 4, again minus 6, because cross multiply means minus 6 will come. So minus 4 minus 6 means minus 10. Therefore, cofactor is equal to minus 18 plus 13, again 32, 0, minus 3, positive 3, 9, 1 and minus 10. Okay, what is our actual cofactor term? Minus 18, 13, 32, 0, minus 3, plus 3, 9, 1, minus 10. But we need adjoint of A. Adjoint of A means transpose of cofactor matrix. So transpose means row, we should write column. So minus 18, 13, 32. Sorry, my dear, this is, you should be right column, isn't it? Minus 18, there is 13, 32. Next term actually 0, minus 3, positive 3. Again, this is actually 9, okay? 9, 1, minus 10, okay? This is adjoint of A. But we need to find out, capital X is equal to A inverse into B. So, therefore, 1 by determinant of A is equal to, what is the value? 27. So 27 into adjoint of A means minus 18, 0, 9, 13, minus 3, positive 1, 32, 3, minus 10. Into B, B means constant actually. 2, 31, 13. So 2, 31, 13. Now, how to simplify one by one. Capital X is equal to 1 by 27. Again, minus 18 into 2 means minus 36. 0 into 1 means plus 0. 9 into 13. So 9 into 13 means, check it there, 3 9s are 27. So 90 plus 27 is equal to 117. What is the value? 117. Second row, 13 into 2 means 26. Next term, minus 3 into 31. So minus 3 into 31 means 30 into 3 means 90. So 1 into 3 means 3. 90 plus 3 is equal to 93. So minus 93. Next term, 1 into 13. So 1 into 13 means plus 13. Next one, third row, 32 into 2 means 64. 3 into 31. So 3 into 31 already you know 93. That is positive 93. Next term, actually there is actually minus 10. So minus into 30, minus 10 into 13 means minus 130. Minus 130. So simplify now. So capital X is equal to 1 by 27. Again, listen my dear friends, 117 minus 36. Okay, 30 minus 117 means நிச்சயமாக என்ன வரும், 112 40 கழிக்கும் கண்டிப்பாக 67. நமக்கு 67 திரும்ப 4 கூட்டியாச்சுன்னு என்ன வரும், 71 சொல்லக்கூடிய. லிசன் மை டியர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ், இதில் வந்துட்டு நிச்சயமாக நமக்கு 117லேருந்து 36 கழிக்கிறோம். அப்போது 40 இது எடுத்துக்கிட்டிங்கன்னா நிச்சயமாக இதில் எவ்வளோ பேலன்ஸ் வரும், 77 வரும். 77 திரும்ப 4 கூட்டம் என்ன வரும், 81. பாசிட்டிவ் 81. நெக்ஸ்ட்டு செகண்ட் ரோ, ஃபஸ்ட்டு பாசிட்டிவ் நம்பரை கூட்டலாம். 26 பிளஸ் 13 இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 39. அப்போது 93 மைனஸ் 14 எடுத்து 93 மைனஸ் 40 93 அதாவது 39 தான் வருது. நம்ம 14 எடுத்து ஈஸியாக சப்ஸ்ட்ராக்ஷன் பண்ணலாம். அதுக்கு தான் நான் 14 எடுத்திருக்கேன். அப்போ என்ன பண்ணலாம், 93 மைனஸ் 14 சொல்லும்போது கண்டிப்பாக 53 வரும். அப்போ 53 ஒன்று கூட்டும்போது மைனஸ் 54. அப்போ செகண்ட் டைம் என்ன வருது பாருங்கள். செகண்ட் ஃபினிஷ் ஆகிடுச்சு. தேர்ட் ரோ என்ன ஆகும், ஃபஸ்ட்டு பாசிட்டிவ் நம்பர் கூட்டுங்க. 90 பிளஸ் 60 150. 150 பிளஸ் 4 154. 154 பிளஸ் 3 இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 157. இப்போ 157 இங்கே மைனஸ் 130 இருக்குது. நிச்சயமாக 27 பேலன்ஸ் வரும். அப்போ பாசிட்டிவ் 27. ஏன்னா பிகர் நம்பர் தான் பாசிட்டிவ் சைன். அப்போ பாசிட்டிவ் 27. அப்போ ஈச் அண்ட் எவ்ரி டைம் நம்ம என்ன பண்ணணும், டிவைடட் பை 27 போடணும். அப்போ கேபிட்டல் எக்ஸ் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 1 பை 27. எகெயின் 81 டிவைடட் பை 27. மைனஸ் 54 டிவைடட் பை 27. 27 டிவைடட் பை 27. தேர்ஃபோர் கேபிட்டல் எக்ஸ் இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு 81 டிவைடட் பை 27 மீன்ஸ் டெஃபினெட்லி we know answer will be 3. Again 2 times, that is actually minus 2. 27 divided by 27 positive 1. So you can say this is called X, second term called Y, third answer called Z. Okay, just we have to check it. I have taken out third equation. What is our third equation? 5X plus 2Y. 5x plus 2y plus 2z. X is equal to what is the value? 3 plus 2 into y is equal to minus 2. Again, z is equal to positive 1. 5, 3 is 15. 2 into minus 2, minus 4. Again, plus 2. 15 plus 2 is equal to 17. 17 minus 4. 17 minus 4 is equal to 13. So, this is our RHS. We have proof. Our proof is correct. Okay, according to the question also, third equation is equal to 13. Okay, therefore, our final answer, x is equal to 3, y is equal to minus 2, z is equal to positive 1. Thanks to viewers. We will continue our next video. Bye-bye.